Please welcome on stage Toastmaster Seema Ramesh.
I can squeeze 5 lemons in 45 seconds. I can cook 2-minute noodles in 1.32 minutes. And I can do the Gayatri Mantra along with paying my respects to Yo-Yo, Honey, Singh, all in the same breath. It's easy. But for the life of me, to prepare and deliver a 4 to 6 minute speech, it's a Herculean task, a Herculean task. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, good evening.
Good evening.
My life can be divided into 2 equal halves. 25 years before my marriage and 25 years after. I was born as the middle child to a dynamic banker and a sweet doting mother in Tanzania, East Africa. Tanzania, the land of the Maasai tribes. My elder brother Sachin, not the Master Blaster, and my younger sister Suja, we were a team. Speaking of my naughty sister, there's this one incident which is still etched in my memory. As a toddler at a community gathering, she went missing all of a sudden. After a massive manhunt, we saw a group of Maasais walking in with her, holding her hands. We were in a state of shock because please understand that the Maasais are known to drink blood. So when they came back with her, bringing her alive, it was a tremendous, tremendous thanksgiving. Over the years, this particular incident made me realize that no matter how illiterate, how uneducated, and how barbaric the Maasais were, they were so kind and sensitive than most of the people that I came across. During the 70s, we shifted base from Tanzania to the Middle East. Some of the best times of my youth were spent in school in Bahrain, the pearl of the Gulf. Living abroad for several years made me realize that being Indian is a matter of pride. My connection with India grew when I decided to pursue my higher studies in Chennai and then in Mumbai. Of course, living in a hostel gave me huge lessons in life. I was teased, tormented, tortured for being an NRI, non-resident idiot, with a fake accent. However, I overcame all these hurdles and graduated in English literature and pursued a career in journalism. I was hell-bent on being a journalist and was really good at writing. I landed a plum job in Mumbai, but my friends, that was the beginning of the end of my career. My mom, a well-educated lady herself, decided that I had to settle down. And believe me, nobody can argue with my mom. So as per the traditions and norms of God's own country, Kerala, Ramesh and I got married. This is the 25th year of our marriage, mine, here in the land of Rosgullas and Mishti Doi. And Ramesh and I share a sense of camaraderie, more than being the typical husband and wife. We are blessed with 2 amazing daughters, Drishya and Iksha, who are young adults now. Now in the beginning, I had mentioned that speaking in public is a huge, a Herculean task for me. Let me explain why. As a kid, I was branded a blabbermouth. I would speak to anyone and everyone who would just listen to me. And then I developed a stammer. It became so acute that by the time I was in primary school, I would just prefer smiling than talking. I developed the stammer and it made me so introverted that years of dedication and years of encouragement by my parents and hours of speech therapy made me speak like this by the time I was 10. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper corn, a peck of pickled pepper corn, Peter Piper picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper corn, where's the peck of pickled pepper corn that Peter Piper picked? And the rest, as they say, is history. I was introduced to the City of Joy Toastmasters Club almost 3 years ago. I went there with the sole intention of enrolling my college-going daughter to enhance her speaking skills. That young lady moved on, and I stayed back. There were times when I used to wonder, what on earth am I doing with these bunch of kids? I mean, I was a fantastic speaker in the 80s and the 90s. What else is left there for me to prove? But believe me, Toastmasters has helped me come out of my cocoon and do something worthwhile. It gives me a sense of immense satisfaction to know that I'm part of somebody's life, to bring them out to speak in public, to help them. Ladies and gentlemen, of all the hats that I have worn and taken off in my life, the Toastmasters hat is here to stay. Thank you. Over to you.
Sensational speech, Toastmaster Seema, and you could see that and feel